वेलकम टू शेठ विद्या मंदिर ऑनलाइन ऑडियो वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज. दिस इज़ योर मैथ्स प्रोफेसर जया शर्मा. विद दिस वीडियो वी विल स्टार्ट विद मैथ्स 1 लेसन नंबर 3 ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस. दिस वीडियो वी विल बी सीइंग ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट बेसिक्स, दैट इज़ द इम्पॉर्टेंट रूल्स विच आर एप्लीकेबल फॉर सॉल्विंग सम्स इन एक्सरसाइज 3.2.
इन 3.2 व्हाट वी नीड टू नो इज हाउ टू फाइंड सॉल्यूशन ऑफ अ ट्रायंगल. Now to find solution of a triangle, there are three rules which we need to know, that is sine rule, cosine rule and projection rule. So let us see each one by one. Very first, sine rule. Here I consider a triangle ABC. Be denoting the angles with capital letters A, B, C, and then the side opposite to each vertex. Now let's say the side opposite to vertex A, we will name it with the small letter of that opposite vertex. Okay, like here is angle A, so opposite side will be small a. This is angle B, so opposite side is small b. And this is angle C, the opposite side will represent by small c. Okay, we'll be using this in writing the rules. Now very first, sine rule. There are different forms also in sine rule, so I'm numbering it. Very first, this sine rule is given by a upon sine a, that is ratio of side and sine of the angle is are equals b upon sine b is equal to c upon sine c. Now let us take this all as equal to some constant. This will be helpful in solving the sums ahead. Now what is that constant? Constant is actually equal to 2r, that is twice the radius of the circumcircle. So if you draw a circumcircle, that is a circle that is touching all the three vertices of a triangle, is a circumcircle, and radius of such a circle is called as circumradius. Let's say we denote it by capital letter R, then this ratio is equal to twice R, that is equal to diameter of such a circumcircle. This is also represented as A upon sine A is equal to B upon sine B is equal to C upon sine C. Do not forget that the sides are written with small letters and the angles are written with capital letters. We denote it as equal to k. This is the constant 2r. Okay. Now the different forms are actually made out of this what we are studying. So if we take these two ratios, okay. Now considering these two, if I bring b here, so I will get a upon b is equal to, the sine a will go here, sine a upon sine b, and then same way you can work out for these two ratios. So you will get b upon c is equal to sine b upon sine c. Okay, next one, if we take it in this way, okay, that is a into sine b, a sine b is equal to b sine a. And same way here for these two, b sine c is equal to c sine b. B sine c is equal to c, no, not capital, small letter c sine b. Okay, so these are the different forms of sine rule, and this is the sine rule which we'll be using in solving the sums ahead. Next is cosine rule. So in cosine rule, while writing cosine rule, we will make use of this cyclic notification of all the three sides. Let's say A, B and C. Okay, we'll be using it in this order. If we are using B, then next you will use C and A. And how, that I'll explain here. Suppose we are writing for A. So cosine rule for a, we will write a square is equal to, and then what comes, b and c. So b square plus c square minus 2, this same thing you have to take, 2bc cos and this angle a. Okay, same way if you go to write for b now. So b square is equal to c square plus a square minus 2, the same thing, ca cos b. I'm taking the angle, so I'm writing capital here. Okay, next is for c square. C square is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab into cos c. Okay, now out of this, suppose if in any sum you are asked to find cos of a given angle or you are asked to find size, then you can use cosine rule. And from this, how to find cos a? Now let's say I take this minus 2bc to LHS, so this will become plus 2bc. So I'm not writing 2bc right now, I'm directly writing, I'll write b square plus c square. I take a square to RHS, that will become minus a square upon this 2bc, which was supposed to be here, that we bring, though it will go in denominator. So this is how you will find cos a. Same way you will get here, cos b is equal to c square plus a square minus b square upon 2ca, and cos c is equal to a square plus b square minus c square upon 2ab. Okay, now these are the three formulae for cos of angles. No need to mug up anything. If you can write this by using the such kind of notification, you know, a b c written in cyclic manner. So if we write this, from this formula we can make cos b, cos a, cos b, cos c formula ahead. Next is our projection rule. Again, this will also be written with respect to triangle ABC. Just remember, we will be taking the same names for the triangle and same sides for the given triangle. Projection rule, let's see how it is written. And once again, if you consider this manner of writing and the cyclic way, it becomes easier to understand and to remember this formula, projection rule. See, now you will write a, it's just matter of practice for some time, and then you will understand and this will fit into your mind how to write. See, what we need to do, I will write a b c. Now first I'm starting with a, so I'll write equal to, and b, leave some space, and write plus c, and then cos this angle plus c cos this angle b. I hope this is understood. I see, it's a second time again, we will write for b. So b is equal to, go in cyclic manner, after b we get c and then a, so we get here c plus a and along with this we have cos this angle a and here cos. Fine, easy. Now the third one, try to write along with me. C is equal to A plus B, and then you'll get cos B and here cos A. So this is projection rule. It's the relation between the sides of a triangle and the cosine of the angles. We will see how these are to be used in solving the sums ahead. Let's try and understand how to write half angle formula. Just check, children, I am actually trying to explain how easily you can try to remember how to make the formulas, how to write them on our own. Okay, not to mug up anything in mathematics. Now again, once again, I'm using this a b c written in cyclic manner. So half angle is, if you are writing for a angle a, sine a, then its half angle would be sine a by 2. Okay, so how you write it, we write root there's a Heron's formula which we are going to use here. Heron's formula, perimeter is A plus B plus C, and in same, semi-perimeter is A plus B plus C upon 2, because semi means half. When you take 2 here, you get 2S is equal to A plus B plus C, okay? So using this here, as sine A upon 2 will be written as, now see, A we are writing, so exclude that and then use B and C as S minus B into S minus C upon, and then multiplication of these two, BC. Understood? Okay, we will write for the remaining two angles. So sine B upon 2 would be root, leave B and then use C and A. So S minus C into S minus A upon CA. Easy? Then sine C upon 2 is equal to root S minus A into S minus B upon AB. Okay, so this is how we will be writing for sine. And next is for cos. Let's see how we write the half angle for cos. Be attentive. This is also very easy to write down. What we will do, cos A upon 2, it is given by root S into S minus A upon BC. Okay, so you just use the same angle for cos and upon the remaining two. Okay, let's try to write for B. Cos B upon 2 will be given by S into S minus B upon CA. Very good. So I hope you are understanding now. So cos C upon 2 will be root S into S minus C upon C. If you leave C, you get AB. Okay, this is how cos rule is given for half angle formula. Next is tan. I will show you how to write tan. I'll give you the trick. Remaining for B and C, you try to write on your own. See, tan is given by sine upon cos. So tan A upon 2 can be written as sine A upon 2 upon cos A upon 2. So simple, you just take this, get S minus B into S minus C upon S into S minus A. Okay, what is it when you try to divide this two? What happens? This upon this, BC gets cancelled and you get S minus B into S minus C upon S into S minus A. So this is how sine, cos and tan half angle formula are to be obtained. Next important formula online is Heron's formula. This we have already done when we were in our 8th standard of schooling. Okay, what we try to find area of triangle, okay, ABC. So using Heron's formula, how area of triangle is obtained. Area of triangle ABC. Now once I write the formula, I hope you will recall everything. S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Yes, S minus C, where S is the semi-perimeter. Next, this is the last one which we need to know to complete sums from 3.2, that is Napier's analogy. Suppose you get to see any sum wherein proof is asked in this form, tan B minus C upon 2. So how we solve it? So the same angle side is taken. Here is B minus C, so we write B minus C, small letter, upon same thing you add, B plus C into, here it is given tan, so you take cot, and then B and C is used, angle A is not there, so cot A upon 2. Okay, so let's try to write down the second form. Suppose it is between A minus B upon 2, so it will be same angle side, we will take A minus B upon A plus B into cot, your AB, and then C is not there, so C upon 2, right? So let's write for third one. You try on your own. And I give you the answer now itself. Okay, so I write now upon A plus C into cot b upon 2. I hope you all got this right. So these are the formulae you need to know very well to solve all the sums in 3.2. Next video we will be seeing sums from exercise.